Hi there, welcome to my build of King Kombat. Actually, I don't know why I'm pointing to the plans. I've got the actual wing on the table in front of me. But this is King Kombat. As you can see, it's a Forza built flying wing. And it's radio controlled. It's going to be powered by my Irvine 20. Now, this is the third in a series of videos where I've been having an overview of the build of this wing. Now, this is all ready for covering. It's been sanded, I've vacuumed it, I've given it a wipe with a very, very damp cloth just to make sure that there's no dust. And so now, the exciting time, or the slightly nerve-wracking time of getting on with the covering. But first, let me just point out, or let me just mention a few of the tools that I'm going to be using while I'm doing this covering. Now, first off, I've got my Prolux digital LCD screened covering iron. I've been using this for 2-3 years. I absolutely love it. I love the digital precision of getting the temperature just where you want it. Now, I've got two towels here. I bought these yesterday new, actually. I thought it was about time I had some new towels. This is just a small hand towel, and I'm just going to place that on the side of the bench next to me. And the covering iron I plug in down here on the near side of the bench, and that's really important to my mind. I used to have an extension lead at the back of the bench. The lead was always trailing over the wing or the fuselage, and it drove me nuts. This way, I've got plugged in here, the lead is always out of the way, or well, not always, but almost always. So it's a really good idea to plug it in down here. And then if you've got a stand for one of these things, throw it out the window and buy yourself a hand towel, because there's nothing worse than trying to put it on a proper stand. Best thing you can do is just plonk it down. You don't even need to look. You just put it on the towel when you're finished with it. This is an all cotton towel. I guess you want something like that rather than nylon, or it's going to perhaps melt it. But just having something you can place it on is brilliant. So that's my advice. I've also got another towel, which is kind of bath-sized towel, I guess. And this I'll be putting down onto my cutting mats, onto my bench, just to prevent any kind of scratching of the balsa while I'm covering, or damaging the film when I've done one side, I've turned it over and I'm working on it. But also, a towel will stop your model, your wing, or if you're doing a fuselage, it'll stop it sliding around on the bench as you're trying to work. It'll just give it that little bit of friction. So a towel is a great thing to work on. So, two towels, iron. Really nice pair of sharp scissors. Quite often when you're coming around a curve, you just need to do a little bit of a snip, and a scalpel or a X-Acto knife won't do. You just want to give it a snip. So, a good pair of sharp scissors. Now I've got two scalpels, number three handle, Swan Morton, and a number four handle, again, Swan Morton. And with the number four handle, I always use the large blades, number 26 blades. With the smaller handle, I either use a 10A, of which this is, and that's a little bit shorter than the 11A, which I also use. And now is not a time to skimp on blades. You can't be changing your blades regularly when you're doing covering, because the last thing you want is a ragged cut. The difference between a good covering and a bad covering can often come down to whether you've done a ragged cut along that leading edge. So really sharp blades, and it's surprising how quickly these will dull when you're using them. So I've got, this is actually got all my blades in, but I've got a load of spare Swan Morton blades. So I will change those regularly. And I've got a jam jar there just to drop the old ones in, so they're safe and out of the way. I've got a 600 2-foot straight edge, and I've also got a longer straight edge just hanging up here, which is my meter straight edge, which I absolutely love, which was my father's, and it's nice that I'm using it now. But that is really good for cutting long lengths, particularly where you've got a wing like this and you want to trim your covering piece to size. So let me put that back hanging up. Now, the film that we're going to be using, I'm going to be using three colours in doing this. Don't judge me. I'm trying to use up some film that I've got bits of, and it's quite a small model, and I've got quite a bit of this, so it's quite nice and bright. So I'm going to do the underside of the model in this. Nice and bright, it's dark, you can see it in the sky, that'll be great. And then on the top surface, I'm going to be using primarily yellow with some kind of red. And I still haven't worked that out yet exactly in my mind how that's going to be. So you'll have to wait and see how that develops. Now, the material I'm using is Lightex, and this is from the World Models in Hong Kong. It's a relatively cheap film, one of the cheapest on the market in actual fact. I've used it extensively. I quite like it. It's a nice lightweight film, and I find it good to use. And with this Lightex, I find that on the iron, I put it on at about 100 degrees C, maybe 102, 3 degrees C, something like that. And when it's all stuck down, I take it up to about 110, 115 degrees C for shrinking it. So those are kind of the two temperatures, but I would recommend that if you're using this or any other film, you practice first and get used to how your film responds. And also, different irons, I mean, if this is saying 100 on here or 110 on here, somebody else's iron might be slightly different at temperature. I'm not sure of the accuracy of this, although I have measured it with a digital thermometer and it seemed pretty good. Now, if you look in the description of this video, the description below the video, you'll find a link to Lightex and the datasheet, so you can look it up. I've also got a review of Lightex that I've done, which you can find a link below as well. And also, I've done a review of this covering iron. So if you want to have a look at those, description below this video. I think that is about it before I start covering. So I'm going to be doing the wing first and then the wing tips. Now, just very briefly, I'm going to be doing the underside of the wing first. I want the top side to be primarily the surface that you see when it's kind of in the hand on the ground or on a stand. And I'm going to do on the underside, it's a nice bright colour, on the underside, and I'm just going to lap it up over that leading edge by maybe quarter of an inch, sort of 5-6 mil, something like that. And also I will wrap it into the aileron bay or the flaperon bay up to the top and then cut it level with that top surface. Now, the reason I'm doing that first is because then I'm going to bring the top over and I'm going to lap that underneath just on the underside of the leading edge, so it's just downwind of the leading edge. And that's got two benefits. The one benefit is that the wind is always pushing against the seam, so it's not trying to force it open and come loose, which is a real benefit. But also, it's downwind of any oil ingress and fuel ingress, because it's an IC, it's a glow engine, so there's going to be fuel, particularly around here from the engine, and I don't want that flowing into the seams, I want it to flow away. So those are the two things primarily that I'm thinking about before I start covering. I think as well, because on this edge down here, it's quite a narrow edge to stick the film onto. So when I do the underside, I won't be shrinking it. I will just be putting it on and then making sure it's all stuck down. I may shrink little bits, but primarily I won't shrink it. And the reason is I want to then put the top cover on and actually stick the film on the top to the film on the bottom. And that will give it a much better grip. If I do just the bottom, I start shrinking it, it will then probably pull off the balsa and be too small, too short. So I'm going to shrink it all at once. And the shrinking I will do primarily with my iron. I have got a hot air gun, but I find they can be a bit fierce. So I may use that, I may not. I'm expecting just to use the iron. I'll be perhaps just explaining things as I go on, but most of this is going to be high speed footage. But hopefully you can glean from what I'm doing, how it's going, and the techniques and how I'm doing it. So let's get on and cover this now. Well, I've now got the covering finished and it's really nice to get to this stage. It's not my favourite part of a build. I much prefer working with the balsa, but it's so nice to get it covered so I can start to fit it out. Now, some bits have gone really well, other bits haven't gone quite so good. And as always, the wingtips gave me a little bit of trouble. You can see the underside is quite nice, and on the top side, the tips could have been a little bit better. But hey, it's going to be way up in the sky, flying fast, so who's going to see it? I mean, seriously, probably the best advice I can give to people covering, and this applies to whether you're a beginner or, you know, an expert, you can't be too critical of yourself. You need to give yourself a break. And if things aren't perfect, you know what? That's kind of fine, really. And if you're not happy with something, leave it until the next day, until you're more relaxed, or, you know, have a look at it afresh the next day. And often things, wrinkles that seem really catastrophic when you did them, the next day you think, that's not so bad. So if you're covering and you're not totally happy, give yourself a break. And you know, it's just one of those things. We're all human. Anyway, that's my end of my philosophy talk. As you can see, I've got the hatch done. I've also got the fins done in black. Now, I haven't put the fins in. I haven't actually finished cutting the slot here. They'll go in a little way, but I haven't cut the slot for the back. And the reason I haven't done that is because if I cut the slot, it's going to have loose edges. I'm tempted to put them fins in, see what it looks like. And I only want to put these in once, because when I pull them out, if I put them in just to see what it looks like, pull them out, it may lift up some of that covering. So I won't slit this covering and put these in until right at the end when I'm finished, essentially. So that is done. Oh, and one last thing. I've put on the wet and dry. Hopefully you can see that on there if I lean right into the camera. So that gives me a really, really good grip to hold this. Whether it'll be enough when I've got the engine full tilt, we'll see. But that's a really secure grip on that now. I've got that that wet and dry on. So I'm going to bring this video to a close and start fitting it out. And that will be the subject of the next video, the finished plane and fully fitted out, and we'll see how it flies. So I hope you'll join me then. And thanks for watching.